my beautiful Capricorn friends, and welcome to your horoscope for December of 2020, where Capricorn, this month, energies shift. They shift out of your sign. Pluto's not going anywhere quite yet, but we have two bigger planets, both your ruling planet Saturn and also Jupiter, moving out of your sign, moving into the energy of Aquarius, so lighting up and giving us our theme for 2021 around your resources, around money, around your values, how you make money. You will have to work for it, but there's also some great reward around your money as well. We also are going to finish this month and finish this year having the last eclipse that we're going to have for 2020. So it's a pretty exciting headline of things that are going on this month because it's a movable month still. And with all of the changes that you've learned and the experiences that you have had in 2020, I think it's made you very resourceful getting prepared for 2021. But first, we've got to get set up and get all of the players in position here in December of 2020. So we'll jump into that in just a second. But first, Capricorn, the eat and greets will continue on this month. We'll have Patricia Walsh here. We'll have Kira Sutherland will be here. Sally Ducharme, Victor Oliver will be here with Draconic Astrology. Peter Burns will be here with Astrology and Palm Reading. We'll have Linda Bird here. If you haven't studied with her, she's absolutely brilliant. Ali Gully will be here. Rose Marcus will be here. So lots of good teachers showing up, ready to share their information and their love of astrology with us. So I look forward to seeing you in the Eat and Greets. And remember, you can always watch the Eat and Greets absolutely ad-free by joining me on Patreon. And you can join me in the description box down below. As well, the Patreon will continue to expand where there will be exclusive Patreon content over on that site as well. All right, Capricorn, let's jump in here and talk about what's going on this month. So first and foremost, the thing to know that this is a highly spiritual month for you. There's a lot going on in the 12th house space. There's a lot that's being sorted out. You're assimilating and breathing in and absorbing and bringing to a close and a rest everything that you have learned, not only in 2020, but over this last 2.5 years. You are really just absorbing and needing to let the soil of you and your life settle and get ready for the new adventure, the new tide to turn. It's going to be birthday season in just a couple weeks as we get into this December timeframe. But this is a spiritual month for you, and I want you to keep that in your focus and your head view, because the answers come from the spiritual place. They come from that pause in between any of your actions or any of your words. Just pause for a minute. Let your intuition, let the energy speak to you through that small voice that is very, very quiet and very subtle, because that's the spiritual place that we're aiming for this month. So December 1st, we see Mercury entering into the energy of Sagittarius, lighting up that 12th house space. Now, Mercury is also going to go out of bounds on the 13th here in this 12th house space. So as Mercury is here in Sagittarius, it's giving you new truths, new ideas. Definitely, I think, a new tolerance, a new patience, and a new optimism in this particular area. The 12th house are all things that are hidden, our spiritual practices, our meditation, things in our lives, our traumas that we're trying to bring to a close, places of solitude, behavior patterns, thinking patterns, illnesses even that we have that we don't know really that we have them until they manifest in some other way. So this is totally a place too of having to get back to creating a spiritual awakening and a spiritual practice for yourself as well. So as Mercury is here, you're thinking, you're talking, you're making decisions from that spiritual place, and then Mercury goes out of bounds. And it's literally like, in order to find this spiritual experience, in order to find the key in your behavior pattern that's maybe keeping you in the same position, you have to go and do research. 12th house, the 12th house, we research all kinds of things behind the scene, and you have to get out of your comfort zone. You're going to go out of bounds to have those conversations, make those decisions. Now, on the 14th of December, we're also going to see a new moon solar eclipse happening right here in the energy of Sagittarius. So you see, the 12th house is really very beefy as we're coming into this month for you. Now, this new moon solar eclipse, you're going to plant your seeds of intention in this 12th house space. What are you willing to transition? What do you want to begin to transition? What do you want to find out? What do you want to research? Where do you want to have some healing? Where do you want to have a deeper, more grounded, more guided spiritual practice? Where do you want to get out of your own way so that you can be successful? Plant those seeds at this solar eclipse. And the solar eclipse gives us a 6-month commitment to watching that happen out. But the way that you're going to do that is like a Sagittarius. You're going to have to discover new truths. You're going to have to see and maybe have teachers that stretch you beyond where you've been able to take yourself in order to have that new experience. Now, on the 15th, it's a little bit of a busy day. We've got Chiron coming out of retrograde in the energy of Aries, and this is going to light up your fourth house space. Chiron in Aries has been so much about the identity, and Chiron itself is this wound, this hole in the soul, right? So we've hurt, we've worked, we've suffered through this. And as Chiron's been in Aries, and we've all been having to relook at our identities, how do I identify myself? It's an asteroid that I also think says, you know, do you know what principles guide who you are as a human being? What do you stand on? What are you about? Right? In the energy of Aries, where are you motivated to be your own warrior with this energy? So through the lens of fighting for that identity, as Chiron is out of retrograde, it's time to roll the shoulders back, stand up, and really go out and be your own sacred soldier in your life. Take this identity of yours out there on the road. You have had Saturn in your sign working on you for the last couple years. You have matured. You are ready. You've crystallized some lessons, especially about yourself. And maybe you didn't learn everything about where you fit and how you fit and how to do things, but I think you've definitely gotten to see some places that you don't belong anymore. Now this Chiron energy, that little asteroid is like, hey, you got to take courage now and come out here and be about those principles and about those things. Now we've also got Venus entering into the energy of Sagittarius at that same time. So as Venus comes into Sagittarius, she's magnifying this area. So truly, romances from the past can definitely come rolling in. And if they do, it's about healing or about seeing what's in the situation. It doesn't mean you have to completely recommit, but they can also come through your dreams. Your ancestors can come through your dream space in that 12th house place. New truths, new things that allow your research of this spiritual awakening, of this coming out of hiding, you know, will be available here. I also love Venus here in this position because it's highly creative. So you could be creating something or working on something behind the scenes and getting ready to launch it as we get into your birthday season, okay? Now on the 17th, Saturn getting out of your sign, ready to get off you for several years, okay? So Saturn's going to move out of your sign into the energy of Aquarius, lighting up the second house space. So I would ask you, as Saturn comes here into the second house, which is about money, income, the creative talents that you have to make money, your passive streams of income, but also your values and your self-esteem. What happened for you between March and July of 2020 besides the pandemic? What happened to your money? What happened to your resources that made you get really, really, really creative? Because you're going to start to crystallize those things. If you've put in the work, Saturn's going to deliver you some rewards. If you've still got some learning in this area, Saturn's going to help you over this next 2 years really solidify this particular area of your chart. Now, because Aquarius in the general is the ruler of your second house of money and the ruler of Aquarius, Uranus, is still retrograde, I do want to tell you that at this point in the month, I think that you really still have to work hard for finances and you have to pay attention to them because the ruler of your money is basically still retrograde, so still asleep. And I also want to tell you that if you are having challenges with making money or moving something forward, as Uranus comes out of retrograde, as we close this year and come to 2021, things will flow forward a little bit more easily as well. Now on the 19th, we see Jupiter now coming into the energy of Aquarius, where Jupiter is ready to expand things. He brings wise expansion to this particular area. So your little fingertips, your reach, how you can go out and make money, how you can share your value, how you can share your possessions. But I really think a lot of this has to do, Capricorn, with how you value the resources that you have. Jupiter's going to show you the wisdom of how to expand that. But also, he's going to, because he is the ruler of your 12th house in the general, be a spiritual planet. He is literally saying around your self-esteem, around the way you value yourself, around your money, you are going to have to develop some faith. You are going to have to get a higher perspective on how you do that. So it's got to come down to a spiritual practice for you around your money this year, because it's really going to be what you're working on, okay? Now on the 20th, we see Mercury coming into the energy of Capricorn, and then on the 21st, it is a super busy day. We've got the Sun coming into the energy of Capricorn, so happy, happy birthday, my Capricorn friends. Your new solar year begins here, and because the solar year begins here, and you're lit up, and Mercury's here, and the Sun is here, and it's just all the Capricorn words and all the light and the vitality, you are our signal here that we're also coming into solstice. So whether you're in the United States, you're in Australia, wherever you're at, you're having a solstice, okay? Which means it's the beginning of something new. And for you, having had Saturn, Jupiter happen for you, really been working on you, I feel like this is where not only do you have that solar year begin, but you have the seasonal change that Capricorn energy brings in that says it's okay for us to take a new direction. It's okay for us to take new life. The next chapter is right here, and we are totally allowed to get in there and start doing it, okay? So I feel like it's a beautiful day. Not to mention on the 21st, we're also going to have that Saturn and Jupiter conjunction. We've been talking about it all year. Some people have been talking about it for decades, and here we are. We land on it. Saturn and Jupiter conjunct together there in the energy of Aquarius, the great mutation. So here, your money, your value, your worth, your use of technology to make money or share your creative gifts, they are going to become very, very mutated, right? Now, that's going to be for good or for worse for some of you, for ease or for challenge for some of you. But this area of your life has to change. It has to come out of being so grounded where Capricorn just does the work because that's what we do. And it has to start to get into the idea space. Capricorn, you know how to do the work in the material plane, but can you move that idea to an airy plane? Can you take an idea of how to do the work and make it social? How do you do that? Because that's going to change things. I also think that this will be a very, very big indicator for you of having to relook at and mutate in your social groups, right? You know, are you trying to have a spiritual experience? Are you trying to get by just by yourself? Capricorn, this is a phenomenal energy, I think, at this great mutation for you to consider very seriously. Who's in your tribe? And how much pressure or how much weight? Is somebody in your tribe carrying more pressure and more weight? What's happening there? Just relook at that and do a little evaluation, okay? But certainly, this conjunction here socially has changed your world and has definitely cracked it open for sure. Now, as we close out the month, Capricorn, we're going to end with a full moon happening in the energy of Cancer. So just across the street, this will light up your seventh house. This means that something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. That's our clue from the full moon. Now, because it's in the energy of Cancer, I immediately think home. You know, that maybe there's a relationship, seventh house, conscious, chosen, one-on-one relationships that is ending or it's changing. You know, this could even be in your conscious, chosen, one-on-one relationships, your open enemies. So if you got to go to court with somebody and the relationship changes because of that, if there's been healing or nourishing or nurturing that has come about in a relationship, this full moon will allow those adjustments to come as well. But I keep having this sense too that there is a very significant shift over this next 4 weeks, Capricorn, that is coming to your family zone. So I would tell you, you know, just keep your eyes on that for sure and make sure that whatever that area is, if there's things going on in the family, that you really nurture and nourish it along. And because this is a cardinal moon, you will be taking action. You'll be taking action to either end or acknowledge or adjust this. It's not very passive. Whatever happens will stimulate you into action for sure. And I always get asked this question, can a full moon bring a breakup to a relationship? Yes, but it can also bring the breakdown that is needed for the relationship to get healthy again if it's not already. If you're not having relationship challenges, I wouldn't worry about anything like that though, okay? All right, Capricorn, it's birthday month. It's birthday time. You're set for the next chapter. You're set for what's next. Now, what are you going to do with this 12th house spiritual experience? Honest, rigorously honest evaluation of your spiritual condition right now so that you have something solid to stand on as you move forward, the research, any of those kinds of things, okay? All right, my Capricorn friends, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I love you and thank you for traveling through 2020 with me. It has been absolutely brilliant and I look forward to seeing you in 2021. Bye, my friends.